We'll go over all the formulas you need to find pH, pOH, acid concentration, and base concentration. Hello everyone, I'm Melissa Maribel, your personal tutor, and let's go over two potential test questions. In question one, we are given the concentration of acid and asked to find the pH, pOH, and base concentration. To find the pH, we will use the pH formula and plug in the given acid concentration. All right, important significant figure note. pH and pOH have specific significant figure rules. When you are given an acid or base concentration, the amount of sig figs you have will be the amount of decimal places the pH and pOH should be rounded to. This is why we get 3.39 as our pH. And note, our pOH will also have two decimal places. Since we just found the pH, we can use this formula and plug in pH to find pOH. Subtract both sides by 3.39 and our pOH is 10.61. Since we just found pOH and we are now finding the concentration of base, we can use this formula and plug in the pOH. Plugging this into your calculator, make sure to press second log and then put the exponent of negative 10.61. Round two sig figs since our initial acid concentration had only two sig figs. This gives us 2.5 times 10 to the negative 11th, and our units are in molarity since concentration is measured in molarity. In question two, we are given the pH and asked to find our acid and base concentrations and the pOH. Starting with part A, since we are given the pH, we can use this formula and solve for the acid concentration. So press second log on your calculator, then input the exponent of negative 8.5, and we get this as our acid concentration. Significant figure note, when we're going from pH to acid concentration, the number of decimal places for the pH tells you how many sig figs to round to. This is why our acid concentration only has one sig fig. Part B. To find our base concentration, we will use this formula and plug in the acid concentration we just found. Divide both sides and we will get this as our base concentration rounded to one sig fig. Part C. There are two formulas we can use to find pOH in this case. Here's the first formula. We'll plug in the base concentration to get this as our pOH. The second formula we could have used instead was this one. And we can plug in our pH, subtract both sides by 8.5, and we would get the same value. Now here's a summary of when to use each formula. When going from your acid concentration to pH, use this formula. Going the opposite way from pH to acid concentration, use this. Now when you're going from your base concentration to pOH, use this formula. Going the opposite way from pOH to base concentration, use this. If you are given the pH and asked to find pOH or going from pOH to pH, use this formula. Going from acid concentration to your base concentration or vice versa, base concentration to acid concentration, use this. If you want to cut your study time in half, I created detailed notes on everything you need to know on acids and bases. You can find that in the description box below, and make sure to check out this other helpful video. And remember, stay determined. You can do this.